And that was the first time it really affected me. That's when you start, like, I just couldn't stop crying, really, to be honest. It's when you feel like in sujood, the closest to Allah. And you can't get any closer. So you really feel it then. And this is the first sujood I ever made in my life.
اللهم ثبتهم على الإيمان وارزقهم أعلى الجنان كما رزقتهم هداية القرآن بالقرآن اهتديت
بالقرآن اهتديت في رحبه تحلو الحياة شوقا إلى المولى أتيت أسلمت روحي للإله نور الحنايا والطلوق لله أعلنت الرجوع آياته تغدو شموع ويفيض في قلبي سنا
نور الحنايا والطلوع لله أعلنت الرجوع آياته تغدو شموع في قلبي سنا
My name is Daniel Benici. I've been Muslim now for 8 years. I was born in the UK and I'm now 26 years of age. I studied in the city of Bath where I went to a Catholic school all my life.
أخي دانيال حدثني عن حياتك قبل الإسلام، حياتك الشبابية في هذه المنطقة الجميلة.
I've been living in Bath since the age of 13, so I spend my whole teenage life here. But luckily for myself, the friends who I surrounded myself with were not bad, and I was still at that age where all what was on my mind was football and going to the park and friends, and so it wasn't that bad.
قبل الإسلام كان دانييل يعتنق الديانة المسيحية، ولكنه لم يكن ملتزما بتعاليمها.
I went to church probably once or twice a year. For Christmas and Easter, and even that was just because I went with my family. It's not because I believed in anything specific.
ما هي أهدافك في ذاك الوقت عندما كنت شاب؟
Actually, when I was a teenager, to be honest, I didn't have any aims or any goals, to be honest, because I felt like at that time, what's the point in having aims and goals? Because the life is just for enjoyment.
تعرف دانيال على الإسلام من خلال أصدقاء اللي كانوا معاه في الجامعة في مدينة بروسل. ولم يكن يعرف دانيال عن الإسلام شيء من قبل ومن خلال علاقته القوية مع أصدقائه قرر أن يقرأ عن الإسلام وللأسف عندما قرأ عن الإسلام وجد أن كل أصدقائه كانوا غير ملتزمين بتعاليم هذا الدين
But I started going to the masjid then. The first time I entered the masjid was actually this one. So I came down here and the first brother I met was also someone from Oman. And he spoke to me about Islam for a little while. My first experience of the masjid was a very positive one. As I mentioned, very sociable, so I felt comfortable talking to everyone. And I started to go more. I used to pray in jama'ah. I used to meet new people. And I started to enjoy the masjid. So I started to realize that what I was doing was not exactly what Islam wanted me to do. But of course, at this time, I wasn't Muslim. And I didn't have any intention to become Muslim. I just wanted to find out more about Islam. But taking the step to go to the masjid for the first time was for me probably the most important step because it was the kind of defining moment. I read quite a few books, and mainly they were to do with the seerah, of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the one book that actually convinced me and kind of showed me that what I always thought was true was this book here of The Fundamentals of Tawheed by Sheikh Bilal Phillips. This was the one that cemented my views and my opinions. And this is what really convinced me and took me further into knowing more about Islam.
ما شاء الله تبارك الرحمن أخي دانيال تسمح لي أشوف هذا الكتاب القيم. الآيات وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون، أرأيت من اتخذ إلهه هواه، قل أرأيتكم إن أتاكم عذاب الله أو أتتكم الساعة أغير الله تدعون إن كنتم صادقين. كتاب قيم فعلا ما شاء الله تبارك الرحمن جمع آيات التوحيد المهمة وكلها اللي في القرآن.
The first time I actually opened the Quran was in English, so I started to read from cover to cover, but I wasn't really taking anything in because it was so much information at the same time. But the one thing that really stood out to me was the continuation of what I had thought from before that, which was the oneness of Allah.
ما هي الآية أو الآيات التي أثرت على قلبك في كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى؟
There's a verse in Surah Taha that says that your God is only Allah.
هي الآية في سورة طه إنما إلهكم الله الذي لا إله إلا هو وسع كل شيء علما. في سورة طه ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى قبل هذه الآية قصة قوم موسى الذين عبدوا العجل، ثم ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى هذه الآية وكأنه يستنكر عليهم عبادة ما دون الله سبحانه وتعالى. فمن تدبر هذه الآية أنا أنصح إخواني وأنصح نفسي أن إحنا كل يوم أو كل أسبوع نأخذ اسم من أسماء الله سبحانه وتعالى، نتدبر هذا الاسم ونعرف هذا الاسم وصفات الله سبحانه وتعالى كي نتقرب إلى ربنا عز وجل.
هداية من فضل ربي يكسو الجمال ربوع قلبي، يخضر إحساسي ودربي وملامحي حين اهتدي.
نور الهداية زار صدري، هو مبتدا عزمت للرحمن أمري وعلى خطى طه مشيت.
That was the time when that kind of really convinced me that everything I thought of in the past kind of it was confirmed and it was true. So I wanted to take the step and take my shahada. I didn't know what to do and how to do it, but there was one evening where I was sat at my computer just on my own. And I thought, well, why am I delaying things? Why, you know, what's the reason? I found that there is no reason. And the people told me, if you do want to be Muslim, then just do it, because there's no time to waste. You don't want to die in a state of not being Muslim. So I took the decision. I took my shahada.
أين كانت وأين نطقت الشهادة؟ وحدثني عن شعورك يعني بشكل تفصيلي. ما هو شعور أخي دانيال عندما نطق بهذه الكلمات؟
The first time I said these words was when I was alone in my house, and it didn't really hit me then. I knew I said it, and I knew I believed it, but it didn't really affect me as much as the first time I actually prayed. And the first time was here in this masjid down there, and I prayed in sujood, and that was the first time it really affected me. That's when you start, like I just couldn't stop crying, really, to be honest. And that's when you feel. When you feel like in sujood, the closest to Allah. And you can't get any closer. So you really feel it then. And this is the first sujood I ever made in my life. This is when you really feel the shahada. Not just words.
اشتكى جوف الظما لما بكى جفني دما والدرب خاف جهنما لجأت للقرآن. يا روضة نحيا بها يا منهجا لأولي النهى يا غيمة نرنو لها وسماؤها القرآن.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا
عبده
ورسوله
بالقرآن.
حلول الحياة أسلمت روحي للإله قربي القرآن برحمه تحلو الحياة شوقا إلى المولى أتاي أسلمت روحي للإله كان المدى شوى حتى كساه الندى والقلب قد أرضى
I'm a young Muslim, only been Muslim 8 years, and what I've learned is that every Muslim needs to do something. Doesn't matter how big or small, but do something, don't do nothing. Present the Islam to others, and the best way to do this is to act as a Muslim. Not just tell people about Islam, but show them. Sometimes you don't have to tell them, but your actions will tell them on their own. For me, one of the most important surahs of the Quran that I ever read was probably one of the first, which is Surah Al-Fatiha. This was because, of course, my reason for becoming Muslim had a lot to do with the concept of Tawheed, of the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
عمر دانييل في الإسلام الآن 8 سنوات فقط. توجه فيها للقرآن بشكل كبير واهتمام بالغ. والغريب أن دانييل عنده سند في قراءة القرآن وإجازة إلى النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. بعضنا يعيش في الإسلام 30 و40 و50 سنة ما عنده القدرة على هذه القراءة، وأخذ سند، والسند يعني أنه أجيز بقراءة صحيحة وسليمة في كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى. دانييل، متى توجهت إلى القرآن ولماذا توجهت إلى القرآن؟
It all started for one day when I thought about learning the very basics of how to read Arabic. I didn't have any aims or goals to reach a certain level, but I thought I need to start to at least be able to read something. So one of my best friends at the time, who was from Oman originally, he was studying in Ba'ath.
بدأت مع دانييل في تلاوة القرآن وتجويده وتعليمه هذا الموضوع بعد إسلامه بفترة. يعني عندما اتفقنا على أن نجلس، يعني وجدت منه الاهتمام ووجدت منه المثابرة على الموضوع، ولفترات طويلة خلال قراءته كنا نلتقي تقريبا يوميا.
We started reading every single day and it would take me probably an hour and a half to read one page. So it was a very slow and painstaking process.
وهذا أدى إلى أنه يعني بحمد الله ختم المصحف قراءة وتلاوة وتجويدا 3 مرات. وكنت على اتصال مع الشيخ الذي أجازني في التلاوة في الأردن، وهو الشيخ عبد الرحمن المحمود، وأخبرني يعني بأنه من يقرأ معي في بريطانيا هو ممكن أن يجيزهم يعني.
And also with his sheikh who we invited from Jordan to come to Bath, and he taught the community as well, and alhamdulillah I managed to finish the Quran with him, and eventually he decided whether or not he wanted to give me the ijazah.
لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أقسم بالنفس اللوامة أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه.
ما كنت أتصور في يوم من الأيام أني أجلس في هذه الجلسة تبارك الرحمن مع واحد شرطي في بريطانيا وأسمع يقرأ القرآن أفضل مما نحن نقرأ. السؤال الأهم من بعد هذه القراءة، تعرف أن تتكلم اللغة العربية، تفهم اللغة العربية؟
In terms of Arabic, I can understand most of Arabic conversation. Of course, when it gets to more complicated words and you know less common words, I struggle a little bit. But I generally understand the topic and the I'd say 70 to 80% of a conversation between two people. And in terms of speaking, I don't actually speak because I don't practice. But I'm sure if I did practice, then it wouldn't take very long because I already have the reading and the understanding in most part. So inshallah, with a bit of practice, the speaking will also arrive.
يا رب نرى أخونا دانييل وتدعو له الآن ممن يشاهدنا، كلنا ندعو له أن يكون من حفظة كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى، يعيش في مجتمع لا يوجد فيه مشايخ قرآنيين متقنين، ولكن يقرأ القرآن بهذه الطريقة، والله نخجل من أنفسنا.
حميم والكتاب المبين، إنا أنزلناه في ليلة مباركة، إنا كنا منذرين.
ما قصة دخول دانيال للشرطة؟ كيف تم قبوله؟ ولماذا اتجه للشرطة؟
One time when I was in the masjid, we just finished praying, and someone came in and he introduced himself as an inspector in the police. I wasn't exposed to the police before, so I didn't have any idea. But I said, "Who are you? And welcome to the masjid. And is everything okay?" He said, "Yes." He said, "I just wanted to let the Muslim community know that there are vacancies in the police. So if anyone wants to apply, more than welcome." So I thought about it, I said, "Yeah, I'm interested. It's not something I thought about before, but why not? It's something interesting." So I applied, and alhamdulillah, I got the job. But before that, there were quite a few interview phases. Before I actually accepted the job of being in the police, of course I was offered the job, but I did not accept at that point because I had three conditions. Was that I had to pray Jum'ah in the masjid, that's 100%. I had to definitely pray my five daily prayers on time whenever it was needed, within, of course, its limit. And the third and final one was to keep the beard, because I wanted to be recognized as a Muslim, especially in this country. I think that's very important. I don't want to hide away as a Muslim. I'm a Muslim, I'm proud of it. So I want to be recognized in the street as a Muslim.
هذا هو المسلم الحق الذي يفتخر ويعتز بتعاليم دينه ويحافظ عليها. للأسف تجد بعض المسلمين في الدول الإسلامية يجمع الصلوات من أجل العمل، وبعضهم يفوت الصلوات. فعلا كان دانيال مثال رائع للشاب الملتزم بتعاليم دينه.
I felt also as a Muslim, it's good to benefit the community in this way, because actually you're removing the harm and implementing the good. So it works well for me. Alhamdulillah, I find it as a great job as a Muslim.
بعد الإسلام وبعد التعمق في الإسلام بدأتم في الدعوة. ما هي أنشطتكم الدعوية هنا في بعث بعد إسلامك؟
Recently, the last event that we had was the tour of the whole of the Southwest region, which included four cities. So it was a talk in every city, and the title of the whole tour was the legacy of Prophet Muhammad in the 21st century.
Alhamdulillah, and with Daniel's help, we've done a few other courses as well. Recently, we had a course on the tafsir of Surah Yusuf and other courses. And alhamdulillah, the young people are coming towards Islam. The more and more young people are coming towards the masjid through the efforts of brothers like Daniel.
We do keep thinking and pondering upon the reason why we are here, just as I did. I did that for many years, and I never actually found the answer until I came across Islam. So my advice, if you are searching, is to keep searching, but to cut the story short, just go straight to Islam, because at the end of the day, that's where you're going to end up anyway.
قبل أن ننتهي كلياً من هذا اللقاء، أريد أن أعرف أمنية أخي الغالي دانيال الدعوية.
In terms of what I want, what I wish, especially for this region, this area of the UK, is for us to continue, or to be able to continue in our work of da'wah, to spread Islam to everyone, including the non-Muslims. So we would like to hold more events, bigger events, across more cities, possibly even a conference, which would be the first conference in the southwest of the UK, where we could invite all the officials at one time, all the non-Muslims, all the Muslims, have a nice day, show what Islam is, show how Muslims behave together. And continue in our work of da'wah.
إخوانك في الويب سايت نون هو داعم لك بإذن الله عز وجل.
جزاكم الله خير.
بارك الله فيك.
شكرا.
شكرا.
يشرق صبح والحاني أرتله وأحفظه وأقرأه بمعاني أسير بدرب قرآني
ربيعي أنس أيامي صديقي بوح أحلامي شفاء الهم والشقوى يداوي جرحي دامي ربيعي أنس أيامي صديقي بوح أحلامي شفاء الهم والشقوى يداوي جرحي دامي ولما تهت ثم أتيت لدرب كلام رب البيت وجدت النور والسلوى مع القرآن اهتديت مع القرآن اهتديت
فيشرق صبح والحاني أرتله وأحفظه وأقرأه بمعاني أسير بدرب القرآن